Let's discuss the Senior Citizens Act, or Republic Act Number 7432, as amended by Republic Act Numbers 9257, 9994, and 10645. What is the concept of a senior citizen? A senior citizen refers to a resident citizen of the Philippines at least 60 years old. It includes Filipinos with dual citizenship status, provided they have at least 6 months residency in the Philippines. A senior citizen is entitled to the following privileges. 1. 20% discount and value-added tax exemption on the payment of the following goods and services for his or her exclusive use and enjoyment: medicines prescribed by his or her attending physician, essential medical supplies, accessories and equipment, professional fees of his or her attending physician, professional fees of licensed home health care workers, medical and dental services, as well as diagnostic and laboratory fees, actual fare for land transportation, actual fare for domestic air and sea transportation, services in hotels, restaurants, and recreation centers, admission fees to theaters, cinema houses, and concert halls, circuses, carnivals, and other similar places of culture, leisure and amusement, and funeral and burial services. 2, exemption from the payment of individual income taxes of minimum wage earners. 3, 5% discount on the monthly water and electricity utility bills. 4, exemption from training fees for socio-economic programs. 5, free medical and dental services in government facilities. 6, educational assistance for post-secondary, tertiary, post-tertiary, vocational, and technical education, as well as short-term courses for retooling in both public and private schools through provision of scholarships, grants, financial aids, subsidies, including support for books, learning materials, and uniform allowance to the extent feasible if the senior citizen meets the minimum admission requirements. 7, continuance of the same benefits and privileges given by the government service insurance system, the social security system, and the home development mutual fund. 8, special discounts in special programs for senior citizens on purchase of basic commodities. 9, express lanes in all commercial and government establishments, or in the absence thereof, priority shall be given to them. And 10, death benefit assistance of a minimum of 2,000 pesos to be given to the nearest surviving relative of a deceased senior citizen. A senior citizen availing of the privileges granted under the Senior Citizens Act must present any of the following documents. 1, identification card issued by the Office of the Senior Citizens Affairs. 2, Philippine passport. And 3, other documents showing the senior citizen's age and Filipino citizenship, such as his or her driver's license, voter's ID, social security system or government service insurance system ID, professional regulation commission card, or postal ID. If goods and services are on promotional discount, the senior citizen can choose between the promotional discount or the 20% discount under the Senior Citizens Act, whichever is higher and more favorable. If the senior citizen is also a person with disability, he or she can choose to avail of the 20% discount under the Magna Carta for Persons with Disability or under the Senior Citizens Act. Incentives for foster care. Individual or non-governmental institutions, homes, residential communities, or retirement villages caring solely for senior citizens are entitled to the following incentives. 1, realty tax holiday for the first 5 years, starting from the first year of operation. And number two, priority in the construction or maintenance of provincial or municipal roads leading to the aforesaid home, residential community, or retirement village. Private entities that employ senior citizens are entitled to an additional deduction from their gross income, equivalent to 15% of the total amount paid as salaries and wages to senior citizens if, one, the senior citizens are continuously employed for a period of at least 6 months, and two, the annual income of the senior citizen does not exceed the latest poverty threshold as determined by the National Statistical Coordination Board of the National Economic and Development Authority for that year.